Awesome. Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining us today, and welcome to the info session on Fuqua's Net Impact Club. Clay and I are really excited to be here with you today and talk about our organization and answer any questions that you might have. We'll start off with a quick introduction. My name is Vanessa Vargo. I am one of the co-presidents, a second-year outgoing co-president. I'm originally from Singapore. I was born and raised there. I came to Fuqua from an accounting background and was looking to pivot into the impact sector, which ultimately led to my involvement at Net Impact Club and the social impact system that exists here within Fuqua. I spent this past summer interning with Accenture, working with a client in the health sector to develop a social impact strategy, and I'm planning on continuing that path post-graduation. I'll let Clay introduce himself.
Hey everyone, I'm Clay Brzezinski. Originally grew up in the Chicago suburbs, went to undergrad at Clemson University, studied engineering. I worked in the auto sector on like transmission developments and electric drivetrains for a little while, spent some time living in Germany, and eventually decided I had some strong feelings about how much better they were doing energy infrastructure and transportation specifically. Made a move over to GE in their wind turbine division. Spent a couple years there still in engineering, and really came to Fuqua to try to solve some bigger enterprise issues. Also spent a summer in consulting, hoping to head toward a career with a little bit more focus on impact investing and impact diligence. So really excited to be here with you today.
Awesome, great. Well, the quick plan or rundown for today, we'll spend a couple minutes giving a quick introduction to what is Net Impact and who we are on campus. And then we will jump into whatever questions that you have prepared for us live. Feel free to start entering those through the Q&A button, and we will try to get to as many questions as we can. So a quick overview who we are. So the Duke NBA Net Impact Club serves as a hub for social and environmental impact here on campus. Our club serves as, and we really serve to kind of bring together both students, alumni, faculty, and staff. And as a professional organization, we aim to provide resources and serve as a bridge through expanding opportunities through programming for students pursuing a career in both traditional and non-traditional impact focus fields. Do you want to go into some of the activities that we do as a club?
Sure. So our biggest, largest keynote activity is we are the host of the Sustainable Business and Social Impact Conference here at Duke Fuqua. So it's the largest sustainable business conference of its kind in the Southeast. We're really excited. It's actually going to be here in just 2 weeks. So we'll plug some websites at the end if you'd like to register. It will be in person in the Triangle area. But this is by far our largest event, really dedicated to bringing in cornerstone speakers in the impact space, across a variety of different fields, panels, and connecting different students and professionals who are interested in this space. Internally, in terms of career resources, we have a social impact bootcamp, an SBSI bootcamp, right at the beginning of the year to kind of build awareness about what types of impact careers there really are, and really bring students together to start forming that community. In terms of partnerships, there's a few other events that I'm sure, Vanessa, you can talk about if you want to, in terms of Engage Germ and Rise Against Hunger. And then we also interact really closely with CASE, EDGE, and some of the different centers here at Fuqua to build up that academic environment, kind of tweak some of the course curriculums around what students are really looking for, things like that.
Yep, happy to jump in terms of community engagement. So we do interact with not only our student population, but Big Duke in general as well. There is a sister Net Impact Club at the Nicholas School of Environment. So we do interact with them quite a bit. There used to be an undergrad chapter of Net Impact. I think they are working through potentially reviving that. But in the larger Durham area as well, we do often work with our somewhat friendly rival down the road at UNC Chapel Hill, the Keenan Flagger Net Impact chapter. We do some work with them as well as NC State. We do quite a bit in terms of community engagement. First years when they do come on campus, something that we host in orientation is called Day in Durham, Engage Durham. It's seen some reiteration around the last couple years, but what we really aim to do is to introduce students to the community. Durham has a super rich history, and we think it's very important for students to understand kind of the space that they live in. And I think you mentioned some of the academics that we have here, but an academic roadmap, both of us, I think, have taken a number of the social entrepreneurship classes here and impact investing, so we're happy to touch upon some of that as well.
Maybe you just want to expand a little bit upon our like career resource offerings too, since we are a professional club here at Fuqua, and that is one of our primary purposes, is to arm students with the resources they need to pursue careers in this field. So in addition to that SBSI bootcamp, we also host a series of Sector 101s where we sit down with a panel of second-year students or alumni who are working or have worked in that field. So those will span from social impact consulting to social impact and nonprofit careers over to sustainability as well. And then throughout the spring, we try to really do a good job of connecting students with mentors who have worked in this space and eventually bring on an impact career track every January, where we'll do a full day of virtual webinar events with different employers to hear about at a sort of informal setting. How did you end up in that role? How did you get there? How's your career been developing since? And kind of build some of those closer connections, since it is a relatively disparate field in terms of all the possible career opportunities, interest areas, and organizations you could join.
Great. So I think a common question that Clay and I get, especially from incoming students, you know, I'm here, there's so much going on, how can I get involved? What are the ways to do that? So I think, like I mentioned, the first thing that is available is kind of Engage Durham. The second time you'll probably hear about Net Impact is during the club fair, and I think that's a great way to register. And I think from there you can kind of join our list server and hear about the different things that we are planning, get involved in some of the activities that we're planning, and the things get rolling pretty quickly, to be quite honest. And there's always things happening here at school. I would definitely advise on being very intentional on what you sign up for, because there is so much that you can do in terms of the impact space.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's a funny time of year, too. So today is the beginning of the co-president elections for all of the professional clubs. So it's the time of year where we start to hand off some of those responsibilities the first years, and you really get to be picky about what you want to lead. I think that's probably a good transition into maybe why we chose to invest in this role.
Yeah,
So I think both of us were on the first year cabinet last year of Net Impact, and different kind of size of the organization. I was working with career resources. And I think we both really felt like this is one of the really most impressive sort of ecosystems at Fuqua. And one of the things I love about Net Impact here is that we're not sort of carrying the load for creating resources and programming. We're just tied into a really incredible ecosystem across Fuqua and wider Duke, between the Nicholas School, CASE, EDGE, CASE I3. So we're just doing a lot of sort of like air traffic control, connecting students with all these incredible resources and helping them kind of identify this is the type of path, this is the type of organization, nonprofit, for-profit, B Corp, that I want to find my impact path toward.
Yeah, I think Clay basically summed it up beautifully. I think the one thing that I would add is just the network and support that does exist. I think Clay kind of alluded to how diverse and vast the field is. And I think one of the biggest challenges students have coming in is really trying to understand what is going on and how can I get to someone that can connect me to the thing that I'm specifically interested in. And I think that's what drew me to Net Impact and why I decided to become co-president is I wanted to be an enabler in this network that does exist in this ecosystem, and how can we help drive that to continue to make connections.
Sure.
So I think we have some questions coming in here.
So I can start to talk about some of the leadership opportunities for SBSI. So the Sustainable Business Social Impact Conference is one of the largest teams of cabinet members in Net Impact. So overall, we have 36 cabinet members, including first and second years. The SBSI team makes up about 10. They are probably large enough to be a club in and of themselves in terms of the resources and how big this event is. But yeah, so there's plenty of opportunities. I think we divided some of the vertical work streams into operations, fundraising, And some of the content in terms of who the speakers are going to be. So you do get to have some degree of voice in who the panelists are. You'll help with some of the outreach to find these people. Obviously, there's a lot of really great connections that we have through Case and Edge, which is how we are able to source some of these really great keynote speakers. So that's for one. Looking next. So in terms of timeline for recruiting in the impact space, it can be a little bit different than some of the other career pathways students are interested in. Some of these organizations, just because they're a little bit smaller and have less like annual demand or maybe more irregular demand for MBA hires, tend to hire a little bit more just in time. So those offers or interviews can come in a little bit more like February, March. That's why we do our impact trek in January to really try to hit the time when most of those organizations might be starting to look for interns. But there are certainly some annual programs like the Red F. Farber Fellows that have a little bit more structured timeline, or like social finance comes on a little bit earlier in the year. So
definitely. And I think one thing to add is what we do as an organization, as we've been alluding to, is really serve as a bridge. So we do have kind of an ongoing list of companies where students have looked at for internships, and maybe if internships opportunities aren't available, full-time offers. So I think it's kind of, we have those resources available, knowing that it's such a customized timeline, and understanding that in the fall, that's when you're really going to be networking, trying to figure out what you want to do, building that network out, and then in the spring, be preparing for interviews, kind of going over, targeting those specific companies, and then preparing for the interview process.
Yeah, absolutely. And just kind of answering a couple more parts of that question, the if you're interested in focusing on sustainability. In terms of Edge or Case, there's really not a hard decision you have to make. Those are resources that are available to you. We can dive into some of the second year fellowships.
Yep.
So we have Case Fellows, Case I3 Fellows, and Edge Fellows. So Case I3 is focused on the Duke Fuqua Impact Investing Initiative. Case focuses a little bit more on social entrepreneurship.
Mm-hmm.
And then Edge on energy development and the global environment. So all of them have slightly different programming and responsibilities. You can do everything from associate with a mentored study, which is you finding an individual employer to work for credit that term, to leading a larger client consulting engagement with a team of first year and second year students.
Yeah.
Do you want to talk a little bit more about like Case Fellows?
Yeah, I think what you're saying is exactly online to what I was going to say. It's not also, or one thing I wanted to add though, it's not mutually exclusive. Like if you do one fellowship, it doesn't mean that you can, or if you're involved with Case, doesn't mean you can't be involved with Edge either. I think one thing to preface is the time commitment and how there's sadly a finite amount of time available during each day and what you want to get involved with. So I think there are plenty of things to do here, and so many wonderful resources. I think it's just figuring out what you want to do and then investing, whether it's Case I3 and impact investing or more the social entrepreneurship space.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's a fair degree of overlap as well. For example, Case I3 may end up with clients in the climate space,
mm-hmm.
Some overlap with Edge there, whereas they may also be working with clients with, for example, like poverty alleviation in the food and farming space. So not mutually exclusive by any stretch.
Yes.
Do you want to talk about some coursework and how kind of the relationship between that impact and maybe what some of the great courses that we've not actually participated in building, but had some input on over the years?
Yes. So I think like we've mentioned, there are a ton of courses that you can take at Fuqua that tie to social impact. We have a larger social entrepreneurship concentration, which you receive if you take a certain classes. There's a social entrepreneurship class, impact investing class, which we've both taken, a social venture capital class, which I think has been one of my favorite classes here at Fuqua so far, not only for the cases that we read, which are very focused on kind of emerging markets and some of the impact work that are occurring over there, just because that's where resources are needed and where funds are interested in going. And then also the speakers and the opportunities that existed throughout that course. So I think there's a lot of opportunities that exist within kind of the academic area in terms of speakers that do come in, and I found it really helpful in shaping my personal career growth. Social impact as an industry is where I see myself long term. Short term, I'm not sure where my career necessarily is going to pivot in the next couple of years, but I think it was great from the course perspective and hearing kind of different employers come in and share kind of their life path helped provide insight into the opportunities that I could have.
Yeah, I think one of the interesting questions that came up is how being involved in NetImpact and specifically the impact space, being involved with Case and Edge, has shaped the Fuqua experience for to make it any different or better. And for me personally, the best part is the community of people involved in NetImpact tend to not just sort of coalesce around their career interests, but a lot of common core values around what they want the world to look like and what type of change they want to see affected in the world. So the actual cohort of people, especially once you get into your case fellows and in your second year groups for some of those fellowships in particular, you just have so much in common with these other students, and there's a lot of self-selection into why people choose NetImpact at a very core level that makes it a really special group of people to connect with. I can also hit on some of the relationships with companies in the consumer goods industry. So definitely a really budding area of the impact space, especially around circularity. One thing I would really look out for is the types of public benefit or like B Corp certified divisions of larger CPG conglomerates. So you'll start to see the Danones and the Unilevers having some of their just divisions certified with those B Corps. And those are the types of corporations, in addition to some companies like Nike, that have started to really pull more demand in that career field, which is one of the cool parts about NetImpact as well, is that it's not just some vertical of clearly defined roles. There's a lot of sort of overlap with consulting, impact investing, CBG. So we don't just have members that are all dedicated to one career field, and especially it's people coming from all different career fields and going to different places. So there's just a lot of diversity and overlap in terms of interests and the knowledge people bring to the table.
Yeah, and a quick plug for SBSI. We do have a supply chain and social procurement panel. As Clay was saying, it's kind of a hot topic area and social impact. So thinking about the conference and the speakers that we want to bring and the topics that are relevant to today's time, we have several companies coming in to run that panel, or not coming in, I think they might be hosted virtually, but to run the panel. So we both have it from kind of the networking career aspect in terms of internship and kind of who we're partnering with to bring on campus to expose the students to.
So doing a little bit of a deeper dive on sustainability in some of the core courses. So core, I think the terminology we would use is the first two fall one and fall two terms, in addition to the summer term at the very beginning, during and sort of past orientation. So sustainability is not covered, I would say, very explicitly in some of those. Later in the core courses, which these are considered core courses, so you have operations and then business and common purpose throughout the spring one and spring two terms. So certainly covered heavily in business and common purpose. And then there's a much larger umbrella of electives that you can look through in terms of some of the Edge seminars. There's plenty of other classes you can kind of dive into that space with, especially among some of the client practicums in terms of experiential learning. I think that's one of the coolest parts that I was maybe truthfully a little skeptical of coming into to Fuqua. I know we're all gonna do an internship. Maybe is it really necessary that I do this client engagement work? And between FCCP, which is sort of the not always impact focused, but could be impact focused projects, then Case I3, there's a really great selection of sustainability focused projects. And I would not underestimate how much learning you do diving with your team as everyone starts to unpack what the client's trying to solve in those issue areas.
going along the topic of sustainability, it looks like we have a question here about kind of synergy between our club and Energy Club. And I would say there's a ton of synergy that does occur, and we do work with them quite a bit throughout the school year and do support each other with our conferences, because we have SBSI and they are one of our sponsors, and they also host an energy conference every year where we in turn are one of their sponsors. So we do spend a lot of time kind of collaborating throughout the school year. EDGE as a center also has an EDGE Student Council, which we sit at with the Energy Club to ensure kind of the overall program with the Food and Ag Club and some other clubs at Fuqua. We're going over kind of the curriculum that we're bringing as organizations to students. So we do work with them quite a bit, and there's a lot of synergies that do happen between the two clubs.
Yeah, and kind of speaking of synergies across some other career fields, I know there's been a little bit of interest in social impact consulting and some of the questions, and I would say, Vanessa, you'll be able to speak to this quite well. Certainly a spectrum of consulting firms that have purely dedicated what we'll call impact work, consulting firms that do both, call it like generalists, but also have certain defined divisions like Accenture, and then others that may not have as clear boundaries of what is impact and what is not, but still do some degree of pro bono or impact focused engagements. So in terms of timeline, it depends on which one of those types of firms you want to go after. In terms of maybe some of the largest consulting firms, those tend to have a pretty fall-heavy recruiting process. And then most of those interviews will take place in January. In terms of some of the really truly impact-only clients, firms like FSG or Bridgespan, those may have more of an ad hoc recruiting process just based on the number of students they're going to take every year. So they may have positions open, they still do have somewhat formal cohorts, but they may not necessarily line up as early as some of the other consulting firms.
Yes. And I think one thing to mention is that some of the social impact focused consulting firms only focused in social impact, those tend to be hit or miss in terms of whether or not they're offering internships, but they do, for the most part, recruit full-time. Not sure about internships, though.
Certainly, some degree of connection with Fuqua. We had FSG speak at our Impact Career Track. I know there's one, Bridgespan offer this year, so a lot of good news in that space, and certainly growing at a lot of the larger, maybe previously more traditionally focused consulting firms over time. I can talk a little bit about the registration process for taking classes at the Nick School, or this will apply also to the Sanford School of Policy.
Yeah.
I think you can take classes at the Pratt Engineering School as well, or the Law School. So you have a lot of options. There's a lot of really incredible, great Duke grad programs to sort of cross-pollinate with. In my experience, it's a lot of hear the classes. One thing to keep in mind is that the list of classes in these other schools may not always overlap perfectly with the Fuqua academic calendar. They may be on a semester system, so that's just one thing to check out, depending on what your spring break plans or something like that, making sure that all lines up. But typically, you'll be able to make a request to that professor. Sometimes, I would say rarely, there are prerequisites. Tend to be a smaller list of classes that MBA students are interested in taking at these other schools. But overwhelmingly, I'd say my classmates have had success in becoming enrolled in those classes. I think typically having the initiative to find classes at another school is certainly not frowned upon and is typically accepted.
I love this question about what achievement are you most proud of within Impact, and I'm happy to go first because I helped lead Engage during this past year, and I think something that's always been very crucial and important, at least part of my life, is how I get involved in my local community. So working with kind of our point of contacts within Durham, or Fuqua, Big Duke, and then within Durham, to just kind of reach out to them to get a better understanding about the local business market. And we ended up having a great conversation of kind of the transformation of Durham from kind of being the what was known historically as the Black Wall Street to modern times and how it's known as a modern innovation hub. And it was great to kind of have the first years jump in right away and learn all of that. stuff, wonderful things about Durham.
No, absolutely. In terms of my greatest achievement, no, that is a great question. I would say at least something I'm most proud of is being involved in helping to put on SBSI, just because of the sheer number of people. And again, it's that community of people who all coalesce around those same ideals and values. Yeah. And just being part of creating that community of people, especially this year, really excited to have it in person, is a really big deal to me. And I can't wait to be here in 2 weeks to witness it live.
Oh, yeah. Definitely gets the campus buzzing.
Yeah.
So I'm happy to touch about on quickly kind of the Career Center recruiting pipelines and what it looks like if you're looking into kind of corporate sustainability. I would say that kind of falls along the custom approach students, where it's a little bit of mix, where CMC, their resources and our resources will have a list of companies that students have previously interned at to really get you going and help you build your network. But it is kind of the responsibility of students and kind of what's popping up on CareerBridge in terms of internship opportunities, specifically in the corporate sustainability space. But I know plenty of people that executed kind of that recruiting process last year and this past year and were able to land similar roles. So
yeah, especially in this space, it's really important to kind of hone the funnel of what you're truly interested in. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of talk about the LAMP list, which is our Career Management Center's sort of structured format for how to identify the places you want to live, the types of roles, functions, and organizations you want to really go after, because there are, especially in this space, just so many different sort of niches and possible interest areas across poverty alleviation to international development, environmental sustainability. There's just a lot you can try to tackle. So really honing that is part of the process, and then building out some structured outreach. I'm going to look at the recent employment lists of these people in these organizations, start the great coffee chat networking process, and start to build some of those connections so that when those roles do open up, you'll kind of be on the tip of their tongue.
Yeah, exactly.
Sure, so I can talk to a little bit about sponsorship in the sustainability and social impact sectors. So that is a really important topic, I think, for international students, because some of these organizations tend to be a little bit smaller, especially when you start to work in NGOs and nonprofit organizations. The operating budgets don't always allow for huge cohorts of sponsored students.
Yeah.
So it is definitely something to be aware of. I think there are definitely a growing number of large Fortune 500, either domestic or international companies, that are definitely more inclined to offer sponsorship to students. I think that's definitely a conversation to have with companies up front.
Yeah.
And you'll start to see a lot of our resources kind of tracking those in terms of what internships and full-time. That's one of the resources we can start to provide as you get on campus and narrow your list of what you're interested in. There are definitely larger organizations.
Yeah.
I think one of the ways to organize the types of different firms or impact organizations is the 2x2 we use of, is it a traditional or impact-focused role and a traditional or impact-focused organization?
Yeah.
And depending on which of those quadrants you're interested in, you'll start to see especially more sponsorship opportunities at just frankly larger organizations.
Yes.
That's not to say they don't exist at smaller ones, but that tends to be the theme.
Great. Let's see if we can find a good last question to end on.
We can certainly venture some opinions there. I'll talk a little bit about, someone had asked about the differences between ESG, impact, and CSR. And the truth is, those are not 100% defined spaces, and you'll see different people, frankly, make different definitions for what they are. We can go through a lot of different impact structures about, are you preventing harm? Are you contributing to solutions or, you know, reducing harm to others? So there's plenty of frameworks out there that we can, you know, based on, you know, your opinions and the types of organizations you're looking at, start to segment those. I think in, at least in impact investing, we talk a lot about how ESG is mostly just negative screens, mm-hmm. And not necessarily positive impacts, and that can be a differentiator there. Corporate social responsibility, going back to like socially responsible investing, had its own definition that sort of evolved to ESG. I'll say the best part about this is that you're at a place where there are real thought leaders like Kathy Clark and Katie, Chris Wedding over at the Nick School, where you'll be around people who are helping to shape this field. And you'll start to really gain an understanding of what some of the nuance is mm-hmm. from the people that have frankly been around since those terms were invented.
Yes.
And have a lot of opinions and really great resources on how to parse all that information out.
Yeah.
And make your pitch for what you care about and the change you want to see.
And I, one last thing to add, because I do feel like the definitions aren't set in stone yet. And I think that's kind of something that drew us into the space and into the organization of Net Impact, is to be part of that conversation of these definitions. And especially in the business world, where it's going to be such a force and where you're really going to be enable change and appropriately define them.
Yeah, no, there's tons of work to be done, and frankly we see internship opportunities, things like impact ratings, where yeah. this is a world that is still being perfectly defined, so we can track toward the type of progress we're trying to deem most important.
Exactly.
So a lot of room for people to participate. So I think with that, we're going to jump to just a couple closing comments. Hopefully we've given you a decent snapshot of Net Impact and some of the different things we're involved in here at Duke Fuqua. If you'd like to learn more, our website is sites.duke.edu/Fuqua Net Impact. No underscores or dots or anything in the Fuqua Net Impact piece. You can also go to sites.duke.edu/Fuqua SBSI if you'd like to look at more information on SBSI or to register. That would be amazing. If we didn't get to your questions today, feel free to contact us afterwards. Our club email is duke.grad@netimpact.org. So we'll be happy to answer some of your questions if we didn't get to them. But other than that, we really appreciate you joining us today, taking time out of your day. We hope you'll be part of Team Fuqua, and let's go Duke.
Have a good one.
All right. Thanks.